In this video, we're going to talk all about classroom morning routines. Routines for teachers and routines for students. Students take comfort in predictability, and that's why your routine should be predictable. My routine starts as soon as I walk through my classroom door. These are the habits that I've developed for sort of the order of things, how I take care of what needs to be done before the students enter the classroom. Everything from make sure all the lights are on, make sure the thermostat is set, unpack my own book bag. This involves things like making sure my lesson plan book is out on my desk, making sure my phone is not in my purse so that I don't have to rifle through it at some point during the day, making sure my laptop is on my desk. My school still has us using desktop computers, but I don't really like to be tied to one area of my classroom, so I do bring my own laptop from home, and making sure it gets set up on my table is part of my routine. Once all of these things are taken care of, I will check email on my laptop, make sure there is nothing that came through during the evening that I'm not aware of for this upcoming day. And then I head over to that desktop computer. I keep these areas as sort of my table is where my laptop is, and then the desktop computer is in the opposite corner. I also allow students to use my desktop if they need it. Once I make my way over to the desktop computer, I open up any Google Docs, Google Slides I know I'm going to need throughout the day. I just like to have multiple tabs open. It just saves time. And again, transition time can be tough. And when teachers aren't prepared, or you know what you want to do, but those couple of clicks never seem to happen as fast as you think they should, going ahead and having those tabs open just makes for a better transition time later during the day. Once the desktop is all set, it's time to turn on the projector and make sure the smart board is calibrated. Once all of these things are done, it's time to make my way over to the whiteboard. This is where I have a section that I call goals for the day, and that's where I write in all of the curriculum goals that I have set for the students so that they can look up and see and know sort of page numbers and what we're going to be doing in each subject area during the day. Predictability is our friend. You may not think so, but it is important to write the entire date on the board and the abbreviated date, because if this is not part of your ritual, then even in fifth grade, I still have students ask, what number is November? You know, where they're trying to abbreviate things, and if I haven't put it on the board, they are going to ask, and having it on the board eliminates the question. Only two more steps for me. The next thing is to go to my closet and pull out any supplies I know we're going to need throughout the day, making transitions faster and easier throughout the day. Do we need colored pencils? Do we need construction paper? Anything like that. Pull it out and put it in the same place every time so that those supplies are easily accessible for the students. The final step is to head to the copier and hope everything goes well. So, you know, that crowd at the copier in the morning, heading over to the copier, checking your mailbox, those are the final things I do before my students arrive. Okay, enough about my routine. What about the students? Let's talk student routines. It may seem dogmatic, or it may seem like you don't trust the students, but in actuality, it's about task analysis, why teachers are so specific about that morning routine. Something simple like, hey, let's unpack our book bags, might be easy for some, but actually unpacking your book bag, but task analysis is how you teach kids to take a larger task and break it down into smaller, more manageable pieces. And for some of the students in the room, this is necessary. They need to know. Unpacking my book bag means taking things out, but where do those things go once I have them out? Do I put books in a cubby? Do I put books in a desk? Do I hang my jacket? Is there a certain hook I have to use? Do lunch boxes go in a particular place? Do water bottles go in a particular place? These are all mental processes that the students are going through, and the only directions given have been unpack your book bag. That's why it has to be routine. That's why it needs to be the same every day. After unpacking, my students know to look to the board, to what kind of independent work has been assigned for the morning. This is, I hate to say, a time filler until everyone can get there. But so it's usually some kind of assignment that's not dependent upon my teaching. It's a reteaching of a previous skill. Sometimes I excel, sometimes a handout that involves review. Morning work can look different ways in different classrooms. Some teachers, especially in the younger grades, like for their students to play learning games together. As they get older, many teachers like for students to work independently on a skill that they've already been taught. Once everyone arrives, we finally are ready for our final step of our morning routine, and that is morning meeting. We go to the meeting place in my classroom. We stand for our morning meeting. I have a whole video about how we do morning meeting in fifth grade, and I'll link that here. Morning meeting is an important part of our day. It only takes 10 or 15 minutes, but it's important for team building and building that sense of community within the classroom and learning a lot about each other and from each other. Once morning meeting is over, it's time to officially start our day. Although morning routines can look different ways in different classrooms, and honestly, some of it's dictated by the furniture in your classroom in terms of flexible seating versus desk, cubbies versus desk, what kind of shelves you have for your classroom library. If, you know, part of your morning routine is to turn in books to the library or check books out from your classroom library, whatever the case may be. So classroom routines can be different based on the teacher. No matter the teacher, no matter the school, the important part is that it is routine, that it's predictable. And that is where the students take comfort, and when they feel comfortable, everybody's day will start smoothly and on a positive note. I hope you will consider subscribing so you don't miss future videos. Bye, teachers.